Welcome to Live Effects, the channel where I do stuff with effect. This time we create the scene where you can look inside of the helicopter. And I want to achieve that without moving the helicopter because I want to put green screen footage inside of it. So let's begin. We start with a fresh composition, but this time it's normal HD and 25 frames per second. Again, I use the drone footage as basis. Now you can see how high the resolution of this footage really is. But I use this to my advantage. Since I don't want to move the helicopter, I have to somehow simulate the movement by animating the camera and the footage in the background. And the first main keyframe is at the 4-second mark. I pull the footage to the left. And the next step is about at the 16-second mark. That's my basis. Now I need my helicopter back. So once again, a new solid element. Go to effect presets, element again, and here we go. This time I use the already assembled helicopter. The propellers are already in a group and set to an aux channel. Let me just check which one it is. This one is channel 2. And this channel 1. Alright, and there it is. Of course not in the way I want it to be. I want to move it and change the orientation, but this time I don't go directly into the replicator. As someone suggested, I will use only the group null to manipulate the element object. This way the element layer stays clean of unnecessary keyframes. The only thing I want to do on the element layer is increasing the size of the helicopter. As I said, I don't want to move the helicopter itself, but of course I want movement in the scene. So what do? I create a camera. So what I try to do here is move the camera to the side of the helicopter and actually take a look inside of the model. Because after this is finished, I want to try put actual green screen footage inside of the helicopter. So let's go to work. Somewhere around there I want to start the camera movement. Now I have to find the correct configuration for the camera that delivers the right feeling of space in that situation. I have to play around with zoom and the focus distance, but that's much easier if you have more than one view. When you activate your four-way view, you can watch your scene in different angles. You have your top, front and right view alongside your active camera. Especially in terms of camera control, the top view is very helpful. Not only can you see where exactly your camera position is, you can also control the position in 3D space and actually see where your focus point is. As you can see, the model has two pilots in front of the cockpit, so I have to be careful that the viewer cannot actually see that they are static objects. The shot begins at the cockpit, but very quickly transitions to the back. I think I have to come back here to find the correct camera setting. For now, let's start and go ahead with the movement. We'll be right back. And for that I go ahead and create some keyframes on the first frame in the camera settings. As I said before, I make this move in the first 4 seconds of this scene. So I jump to the 4 second mark and pull the camera to the left. I know that this helicopter has 2 big windows on the side. When I pass the first window, I want to put the first green screen soldier at this place. And then at the 4 second mark, I want to unveil the second window where the prisoner will be seen for the first time. If I can pull it off, the helicopter is filled with soldiers that are supposed to guard this prisoner. At this place, the first soldier will sit. And here we have the big chamber, the place where the prisoner will sit alongside with his guards. This point and this scene will be very important later on. Not only do you see the main character of the short, but you will also see green screen footage in a computer generated set, so I have to do my very best to sell this exact moment, because most viewers will probably decide right here and there if they want to watch the rest of the short. So the basic camera movement is ready. Now it's time to sell the illusion that the helicopter is still flying. And to do this, I will use once again an expression on the X rotation. And this will of course not move the helicopter, but the camera. That way the Element 3D object doesn't move, which will make it easier to put green screen footage inside of it, but also sells the illusion that the helicopter is moving up and down. And the expression I use is again wiggle, and I go ahead and play around with it to find the correct setting. Now that I have the camera movement down, I go ahead and approve the lighting. And to do that, I will once again use image-based lighting. If you want a few more details about it, you can find these in episode 4. This time I rush through the necessary steps. Look at for an enormous difference it makes if you choose the footage as environment. The reflection will help to sell the effect afterwards. But now back to the lighting. You can see how this little trick makes a difference like day and night. Let me show you how this frame alone changes by manipulating the circumstances. First, I create an ambient light with 50% intensity. Now I deactivate the reflection path of the helicopter. And I toggle the light on and off, just so that you can see how immense the light affects the shot. So I want to do one more thing in this episode. The setting of this camera layer with zoom and focus distance delivers this look. But I want to try to use one alternative approach for the settings. As reference point, I use the moment where I want to sit the prisoner in the helicopter. But I don't want to overwrite what I have so far, so I copy my camera and now I can switch between two completely different camera settings. In this version, I want to try to make the zoom and the focus distance very low, but move the camera very close. This should create a completely different feel for the space in the helicopter. So what do you guys think? Camera 1 or camera 2? Let me know in the comments which camera you like best. And as always, if you have any ideas how to improve the scene, the shot, or anything else, let me know. This time I only prepared the helicopter, but next time it's time for some green screen. So I give this a quick render and we see us next time.